Hold on to me as we go, as we roll down this unfamiliar road. And although this wave is stringing us along, just know you're not alone. 'Cause I'm gonna make this place your home.
Wednesday night before showing starts, I was able to get Dakota into the Coliseum where we were going to show. I just wanted to get him into the arena and let him see the environment and just get a nice session in, get him comfortable. And I really expected him to be really nervous with the stands and having people sitting up top, but he was super comfortable. When I let him loosen the round pen to practice for our class, he rolled and he was super happy. And he even sat up for a few seconds, which was so funny. But I took this chance with the round pen there to practice handling conditioning where we release our horse into the pen. I wanted to make sure his callback and draw was still there, even being in this environment. And clearly he came right up to me, which was awesome. I was super happy with that. While I'm super happy that Coda was relaxed enough to take a roll in the arena, the downside is that he's now orange and we show first thing in the morning. So we had to do a last minute bath using our Green Horse Organic shampoo and conditioner. So with Thursday morning came the first day of showing. And our first class was handling and conditioning. And out of 33 youth competitors, Coda and I were the first to go, which was super nerve-wracking. So So in handling and conditioning, we have to walk our horse into the round pen and release them. And while they're in there by themselves, they'll be judged on body conditioning and grooming. And of course, they have to judge their grooming before my horse rolls and becomes orange again. But either way, I'm really happy with him and him rolling in there. It just means he's relaxed and comfortable, which I'm just really happy with because this is a very big, high energy environment. And when I stepped into the round pen, his draw was really great. He right away gave me his attention and walked up to me. And I did teach Coda how to halter himself, and he demonstrated that really well here. I was kind of nervous. I was thinking he might not be able to do that with the energy of the Coliseum, but he still was great. And even when he brought his head away from me, just the slightest bit, it was still really good, and he kept it there. I was really happy with that. And it took me forever to tie his halter because my hands were shaking. I was really nervous. It just took me a very good amount of time to get his halter on, but he stood there really patient, and I was just really happy with that. Next, we have to bring our horse next to the barrel and brush them off. You can either hold your rope or ground tie your horse. I chose to ground tie Coda because he does know that very well. And I was kind of worried he was going to be scared of the judges sitting right next to him, but he just stood perfectly still. He didn't try to sniff the barrel and walk over to it. He didn't put his head down. He just stood there really patiently. And I was really happy with that. From there, we have to move right into a trot departure. And he's a very lazy horse, so I was worried he wouldn't do that, but he did really great. And we go into our halt and backup. And he has a nice soft backup. He did get a little crooked at the end, so I tried to correct that by bringing his haunches over, which was kind of sluggish, but he still did it. So that could have been better, but I was still happy with it. And then we go into picking up their feet. Coda knows to pick up his legs from me when I snap my fingers, and he responded really well. He was really focusing on me here, and I was really happy with that. I didn't think he would be able to give me his full attention, but he did really well. And even when he put his head down, I just told him to bring his head up, and he brought it right back up. So like I said, he was just really paying attention to me, and I was really happy with that. So the last part of this class is trailer loading, and after being in a trailer for 15 hours and having a foreign trailer in front of him, he did hesitate for a second, but he still got right in. I was totally fine with him hesitating because he's been doing really amazing this class, and like I said, it's a foreign trailer, so I did expect him to have a little bit of a hesitation, but he backed out really nice, and he had a few good steps of a soft backup afterwards, and that wraps up that class, and I was super happy with him. Our second day of showing consists of the trail class, and someone brought out a few obstacles into the warm-up arena, so I took that chance to practice a little bit with him. So we start our trail class with a gate. We have to work the gate with our horse the best to our abilities. So I brought him up alongside of it and decided to do it left-handed. And there is a panel right on the other side of it, so it's pretty difficult to keep them straight. So I kind of just did what I could, and he did really well with it. And I just brought him up, straightened him out, and pivoted him away from the gate, and he did really great. And now we're moving to our next obstacle. Next, we move right into the bridge, and we have to walk with our horse over this. We're not allowed to go next to them. And right after the bridge, there are trot logs, which were super close to the bridge, so it was a little difficult, but he did good. And we go right into the backup chute with all the scary brush all around it, and he did fine with that. He did get a little stuck for a second there, but he still did really good. And I still love how soft he was with his backup. I was really happy with him. and then we go to our side pass. We have to take a few steps to the left first, and then go right into our side pass to the right, and we just have to go to the center of this pole. Kneaded really good. After the side pass, we have to move right into a trot and trot the pinwheel. And it's okay if we're not going over the poles as long as we keep our horse moving around it. And we haven't practiced that too much, so I was really happy with how we did that. And then we have the simple walking over the poles there. And we walk right into our box where we have to do some pivoting. So when we get into the box, we start our pivot with a 180 to the right, and we're not allowed to step out of the box, we have to stay in it. And you did really good there. And then we do 180 to the left. And this is when they let in the other horse. So he looked at it, but he still kept doing what he was supposed to do. So I was really happy with him. And to make sure I stay in the box, I backed him up a step and we were done. And he did really amazing. I was super happy with him. He was just blowing me away at this point.
And in first place in handling and conditioning, Kat Zimmerman. In first place for Youth Trail, Kat Zimmerman. In third place, Kat Zimmerman. In first place, receiving $3,000 and a cut above belt buckle and a resist all patent certificate. The winner is Kat Zimmerman at Dakota.
Following my journey with Coda, you almost whacked me in the face, and following our experience at the Mustang Makeover. It was absolutely amazing, and I really couldn't have asked for a better last Mustang Makeover. If you don't follow me on Facebook or Instagram, this Mustang Makeover with Dakota was my last competition as a youth. I'm turning 18 in April, and that means I'm no longer eligible for the youth division. And I'm choosing to take a little bit of a break, but as soon as I can apply for a Mustang Makeover as an adult trainer, I'm going to be doing so. So that might be at the end of this year or the beginning of next year. I'll be training Mustangs throughout the year nonstop, so there's always going to be material for me to share with you guys. But as far as the competitions go, that's going to be a little slow for now. But to get back on track, I couldn't have asked for a better last experience as a youth trainer. I drew an amazing horse, and as soon as I got a photo sent to me of him when I was competing in Georgia and I had someone go pick him up for me, I knew that he was going to be something special. I felt something in my heart, and I know it sounds so cheesy, but I really did. I knew something was special about this horse and that we were going to share an amazing journey together. And this past weekend with him was phenomenal, and he just blew me away, and it makes me really emotional to talk about. He is going to be leaving next week. He has had an adopter for a few months now that's been following his journey, and she loves him, and I think it's a really good match. He's not going to be too far away, but he's leaving next week. It's really sad. He's going to be my second Mustang makeover horse out of 9 to get rehomed. And the first one I rehomed ended up back with me. So he's the first one to leave again, because I technically have all my other 8 here. So it's really emotional. And I love this little Mustang so much. He is so special and he's so amazing. But I'm doing what I'm supposed to do, and I'm rehoming them and getting them into great homes so I can save more. So no matter how sad it is, it's, you know, everything's ending well. But yeah, again, thank you guys so much, and I really look forward to sharing more of my training this year as I go slower, and I have more time to get material out for you guys. So I'm really looking forward to sharing more training and fun things with you guys as far as my job as a horse trainer goes. So yeah, thank you guys so much.